This is one of the ways in which Subversion helps you get away from the fact when you started typing in Vim in command mode and splat.
What did VI do to me?
All right.
Here's an example. I run a diff on freeform get text. It shows me that revision 4 is the repository one. This guy is my working copy. Okay, so plus I've added a header, right? And then everything else is the same. And then down at the bottom I've added another verse couplet. I never said I was a good poet. Okay? I just know how to use Subversion to facilitate my poetry. Options to SVN GIF. I think I've covered this. This is the args. You know what? I think
maybe if you just use that,
you can just use dash X and feed it some arg that means to GNU diff, ignore whitespace.
V capital V.
And he might be golden. So I will post such to the list. I mean, after I determine that it actually works. Sorry, go ahead. Did I hear a question from someone? No, I'm hearing things. Great.
Does this output have any compatibility with patch command?
Yes. You can take the output of SVN diff and feed it, save it off as a patch file, mm-hmm. and just run patch. Mm-hmm. It'll work.
Ooh.
Yeah, patch loves unified diffs. Those are so easy to apply because they have line numbers and chunks and hurrah. And I actually wrote a. I don't know why the hell I did this, but I wrote a how-to on if you need to actually go into a unified diff and tweak things. So I reverse engineered it. I'm sure that there's no reason you ever have to do that, but I did once, so I wrote it.
This
was also while my deadline was looming. I was working, you know, past midnight, but whatever. I've never claimed to be right. No, my intelligence is high, my wisdom, kind of lowish, in D&D terms.
Wow. So back to diff. This tells you specific revision, this tells you range of revisions. SVN log. Like I said, as long as you commit with meaningful log messages, they can be so wonderful. It can save you so much time.
Because, you know, reading diff is not fun, exactly. It's not exactly hard, but it makes you think, and we don't like to think. So we can read log messages much easier. I mean, it's just regular old English or German or Japanese or whatever. Subversion? Unicode? Good. Hurrah. Me like you. Says Subversion about Unicode. That's what I was trying to say. So run SVN log on a file, and you get all of the log statements. So you can see at each revision what my commit actually did. I mean, according to my log message. And there's no guarantees that my log message has any relation to reality in a meaningful fashion, however, mm-hmm. if you trust me. Useful options, which is a mistake. Useful options to SVN log, same revision stuff. Stop on copy is very useful. I will bring that up later when we talk about branching. XML output, you can get your SVN log stuff in an XML file. So if you're writing some sort of web utility, you know, XML, the web, they love each other, kissing cousins.
When you use minus R and you ask for a range, what actually are you doing?
You're saying, basically, show me all log messages between this revision and that.
So that option only will work with certain commands.
You'd be surprised. It works with a lot of them. It works with update. It works with diff. It works with log. It works with checkout. Lots of stuff.
Kind of scary too, right?
Kind of what you need usually.
Yeah, it is useful. But it isn't scary because Subversion knows revision numbers and it'll tell you. So it's only scary if you don't know that the current head revision is like 26,000 something, and you're playing with revision 7. Maybe that's scary. SVN blame. I love the name of this. I mean, tell you, when you're working in a team of more than three developers, chances are one of them is a bloody moron, and he's always screwing up things. Maybe not at your company, right?
We all have brain parts. Yeah.
All right, so even if you're not a moron, everybody has their stupid moments. So what Blaine does is says, aha, it was this fellow who had the stupid moments.
Crucify him.
And so on.
That's the same thing as CBS annotate, right?
Yes, it is. CBS annotate. So in Subversion, they changed it to Blaine, which is better.
Yeah, it sounds better.
It does. I mean,
I get to get views like that so often.
Yeah. Because, we're geese. Call a spade a spade. If you're wrong, you're wrong. I mean, shit. Not that I'm ever wrong, so. Alright. So, somebody doesn't like my poetry.
Freeform poem that sucks,
says Play Ada. Alright, well, I don't like that, because I think my poetry is rather good, so I want to find out the bastard who's hating on me, and I do with this game. So, with Subversion, you must be slightly more clever when you insult your fellow coders, or when you just mess up. SVN Revert is when you've just made a bloody mess of things, and you're throwing up your hands, and you're saying, just give me the last clean thing. This flows. Okay, revert by default is not recursive. I believe this is the only Subversion command where that is true, but it makes sense. Revert is a little dangerous. Okay, revert is one of those commands that is not really undoable because you're just blowing away changes to your working copy. I don't believe there's a way to undo revert. If anybody knows better, tell me. But I don't think so. Because revert screws away all the changes in your working copy and goes back to the last repository thingy. So unless you act it up outside of Subversion, revert's the end of the line for you, buddy. Now, since I've said that, let me make sure to point out that revert is one of the very few things in Subversion that you can do that is not undoable. Commits are undoable. Deletes are undoable. Anything is undoable. And for all you CBS users, here's something to look forward to in Subversion. Directory deletes are undoable. Because directories are reversions. Yeah? CBS, if you blow away a directory in the repository, it's gone, buddy. You ain't getting it back with any CBS commands. I mean, you pull it off the tape, maybe, but... tape? Pull it off the wire. All right. Okay. SVN copy. SVN copy is actually what you use to branch, and that should make sense because I said, okay, let's say I'm writing a .c file, and I realize that I now have like 45 classes in one file, and it makes sense maybe to have them in 45 different files. What you can do is you can SVN copy them to your other targets. You can, take out the, whatever. You know how what I'm talking about, I hope. So, here's my example. I'm going to copy my freeform poem to a new file because I want to rework it in iambic pentameter because I realize freeform poetry sucks. Or I'm no good at it. I don't know. This is my example, so actually I'm a brilliant poet.
You're just saving the best for last.
So, and then, again, once I've copied, I must commit. Because in general... every SVN command you do, except for commit.
Can I interrupt your presentation? Can we get some of these chairs back here?
Yeah.
A lot of people are coming down.
Beyond where I copied it. So that's what stop on copy does. You understand what this means? You know, when a cell divides into two cells, you only care about this one. You don't care about what the parent cell did before it divided. I don't know why. Where do I